And due to circumstances beyond our control, we're back on this Tuesday edition of Wake Up Wenatchee Valley, 25th day of January, 2022. I'm Dan Kuntz in the captain's chair. Thanks for starting your day with us. Cloudy, foggy, here we go again. 25 degrees, should see a little more daylight today, a little more sunlight than we had on yesterday, but we're still under that influence of that high pressure ridge that's centered over the Seattle area. And it's kind of just stay there. It's gonna eventually break down and move away, but in the meantime, we're gonna be stuck with this pattern of low clouds and fog for most of the day with some late afternoon sun breaks, cooler than normal temperatures. Remember a couple of days ago, they were predicting we could see highs maybe pushing 40 this week. That's off the board. You can forget about that. Forecast details are coming up. Again, if you're looking for sunshine, you gotta go up. You get above the cloud cover, you go up to the major mountain passes, the ski resorts. They're gonna have temperatures near 40 up there with kind of soft snow, but that's where the sunlight is. Not gonna be down here for the most part. Forecast details are coming up. Passes, fine. News, lots, sports, hockey, preps, got all of that to talk about. And a programming reminder, if you are at all interested in the process of selecting the Apple Blossom Royal Court. Of course, they had 30 yesterday. Today, they'll whittle it down to 10. And then on February 19th, we'll have our queen and our two princesses starting at 10 o'clock this morning on our Facebook page. It's speech time. And we'll have that for you. I think it's going to take, I don't know, 3 hours perhaps. All 30 candidates will give their speeches before the judges. And then tonight, not only on our Facebook page, but on television at 6 o'clock tonight, we will have the top 10 announcement right here on the NCW Life channel. So proud to bring that to you. Let's start our tour around north central Washington with our Valley View cameras. Again, with the clouds and the fog and the low stratus, not a lot of cameras to use this morning. We can use any of the cameras, but you want to see something, do you not? And that's what we're going to see right now from the roof of the Cascadian pointed south in downtown Wenatchee. Speaking of downtown Wenatchee, my guest in the back half of the program, Linda Haglund, the executive director of the WDA. They're bringing First Fridays back on a Friday the 4th of February, and they got the big annual auction and celebratory dinner. It's the big party they throw every year to shower kudos on the downtown businesses. All that will be coming up with Linda in the back half of the program. Good morning, downtown Wenatchee. Camera 2, don't know. Uriah gets to choose. He wants to go take a look at gray skies, and is that Stamen Flats? That is Stamen Flats. So there you go. That's US 97A at the bottom of your screen with the one car on the way up. You look across the river and you can see a swath of Douglas County and a little bit of traffic on US 2, US 97 on the east side of the Columbia River. You can see a couple of headlights there. Outside of that, pretty foggy and pretty cloudy as they head on up to Lake Chelan, camera number 3. I don't think anybody has any clear skies except that. Again, you get up above it and you're in good shape. That looks to be either the Waterville camera or maybe Rude Canyon. That's the Rude Canyon camera. So that is Waterville that's out there, but that's a perfect example of what I was just talking about. That's, you know, over 4,000 feet in elevation. That's where the daylight is. That's where your vitamin E is if you need your fix of daylight. You got to go up. But Waterville itself, as you can see, is covered in clouds. And finally, camera 4. Some spectacular views this morning. Oh, that's a lovely view of that area there with the trees and the houses and the roads and the clouds and the fog and the mud and the blood and the beer. I have no idea what we're looking at here, right? That's the Manson Water Tower. Okay, well, there's the lake out there, full of H2O. Good morning to Manson. How you doing? That's the Manson Water Tower, which is pretty close to downtown Manson. So somewhere out there is Lake Chelan. I'm pretty sure it hasn't gone anywhere. Let's talk about weather next week, because things are going to change. Things are going to change as we say goodbye to January and welcome February. Colder temperatures and a better chance of snow heading our way. Probably the snow will be relegated to the Cascades and the Idaho Panhandle, but we could get a little dice of snow in the early part of next week as we say hello to February on Tuesday of next week. 1 week from today is February. Days are getting longer. But we're in for a change after a pretty stable and dry and foggy and cloudy with some late afternoon sun breaks. The fog and the stratus will persist, but it will be disappearing over the weekend. The high pressure ridge will break down, move out of the way, and that will make more active weather as we get into next week. By the way, yesterday's high was 30 degrees. That was it. Normally we hit 35 degrees. Sunrise this morning, 7:35. Sunset this afternoon, 4:52. 9 hours and 17 minutes of daylight. Gaining about 2 minutes of daylight a day. And we will take it. The more daylight, the happier we are. From the National Weather Service. Take a look-see. Again, going to see a little bit more sunshine than we did yesterday. Took a while for the clouds and the fog to burn off, and we didn't warm up very well. But that 30-degree mark is pretty much what we hit yesterday. It's exactly what we hit yesterday, as a matter of fact. Still some patchy fog, but it's the fog and the clouds right now in the Wenatchee Valley aren't as thick and aren't as dense as they were yesterday at this time when we had a dense fog advisory, as a matter of fact. So we will see a little bit more sunshine on this Tuesday. 22 for the overnight low with the clouds and the fog reforming. Clouds and the fog are going to have the better part of the day on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. It's pretty much the same forecast actually through Saturday, but we could still see some late afternoon sun breaks for maybe about an hour or so in the very latest part of the day when the sun is at its apex. It's a possibility. A little bit warmer with the clouds and the fog hanging around in the overnight hours. That's going to make our overnight lows just a little bit warmer as we get into the weekend. And as I mentioned before, Saturday and Sunday, really starting on Sunday, is when that high pressure ridge, which is keeping the clouds and the fog pretty low in the Pacific Northwest, is going to start breaking down, dissipating, and we'll start warming up with more active weather by the time we get to Sunday afternoon, Monday, and right on into Tuesday. Your past report brought to you by D.A. Davidson, the strength of a trusted partner and personalized solutions to meet your financial needs. Remember, SIPC. Passes, you have no advisories, no restrictions, you're fine. That is Stevens Pass. Roadway is bare and dry, clear skies. Going to be a beautiful day up there on Stevens Pass. To Blewett we go. And again, nothing to worry about. I don't know if the camera in Blewett is working. Cameras have been on the fritz most of the morning. There we go. Blewett Pass, bare and dry, patches of frost and ice, no advisories, no restrictions, and on I-90, Snoqualmie Pass. Just do it all again. Rinse and repeat. No advisories, no restrictions. You're pretty much bare and dry. There's absolutely no precipitation in the mountain passes for the forecast. Hello, I-90. None at all until Saturday night. And even then, it's just going to be a little bit of chance of snow on Saturday night and Sunday. Best chance of measurable snow in the Cascades, not until Sunday night into Monday. So all the rest of this week and really for most of the weekend, if you're traveling over the river and through the woods to grandmother's house, you're not going to have any issues at all. No advisories, no restrictions. The weather is just fine. In fact, the weather at the pass summit is going to be nicer than down here. They're going to have warmer temperatures and sunshine. They'll be above the clouds and the fog. Okay, you're up to date with the weather and the passes, and in 1 minute, you'll be up to date with what's making headlines. On this Tuesday morning, you're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
Hi, I'm Katie Joslin, and I'm a pediatrician at CVCH. I would like to address some of the hesitancy that many parents may be feeling about the COVID-19 vaccine for their young child. My husband and I both work in the medical field, and we have reviewed the research, and we determined that this vaccine is far safer for our child than getting a COVID-19 infection. I encourage you to talk to your provider and find out if the COVID-19 vaccine is the right choice for your child.
Find ageless beauty at Chelan Valley Skincare. Cindy offers the most up-to-date treatments for personalized skincare. If sagging skin or acne scars are some skin challenges for you, Chelan Valley Skincare offers non-invasive, non-surgical skincare. With up-to-date technology for shorter treatment plans, you'll benefit from Cindy's expertise to help you accomplish your skincare goals. Please stop by their website for details on all their services. Call Cindy today for your free consultation.
It's cloudy, it's foggy, it's 26 degrees outside of our studios in downtown Wenatchee. Clouds and fog, pretty much like yesterday, only not as dense, not as thick, with a little bit more sunshine on this Tuesday, but then the clouds and the fog will have the upper hand for most of the week and into the weekend. Let's start with this story. An alleged drunk driver faces multiple charges after a two-car accident last night in Ephrata sent three people to the hospital. The Washington State Patrol reports that shortly after 10 p.m. last night, 22-year-old Andrew M. Batty was driving a 1997 Honda Civic hatchback westbound on State Route 28 near Martin Road when he attempted to pass a car in a no-passing zone and then struck the car when he tried to swerve back onto the westbound lane. The hatchback rolled and came to rest on its top while the other car, a 1999 Civic Coupe, came to a stop after striking a rock wall. Batty was transported to Columbia Basin Hospital in Ephrata. His passenger, 42-year-old Jennifer M. Reynolds, was transported to Samaritan Hospital in Moses Lake. The driver of the Civic, a 17-year-old male from Ephrata, was also taken to Columbia Basin Hospital. Batty faces charges of DUI, vehicular assault, and making an illegal pass. Further evidence that the Omicron variant of the COVID-19 pandemic is sweeping through our area. The latest numbers yesterday from the Chelan Douglas Health District, well, we topped 3,000 new cases now per 100,000 population over the last couple of weeks. The Chelan Douglas Health District reporting yesterday, the rate is now 3,151 per 100,000 residents over the last couple of weeks. It was just 2 weeks ago that the new case rate exceeded 1,000, then it quickly topped 2,000 for the first time since the pandemic began 2 years ago. As recently as late December, the rate was only at 214 per 100,000 residents over the previous 2 weeks. The health district said there are 12 Chelan County and 9 Douglas County residents currently hospitalized with COVID-19. A man serving 22 years in prison for assaulting two Wenatchee police officers 7 years ago was apparently sentenced to less time than he should have received. Back in 2015, that man, Jake Van Wyck, broke the wrist of one officer and shot another in the eye with her own taser when they confronted him for breaking into an abandoned home. He pled guilty at the time to two counts of first-degree assault and one of attempting to disarm a police officer. He's been in prison ever since. But lawyers recently found that Van Wyck's offender score, that's the numeric formula that determines the length of a criminal sentence, was calculated too low. Well, in Chelan County Superior Court this month, Van Wyck told Judge Travis Brandt he might seek to withdraw his plea and instead ask for a trial. Another hearing on the issue is scheduled for February 23rd. U.S. Representative Kim Schreier will be in Wenatchee later on today, and she's bringing a guest with her, an undersecretary from the U.S. Department of Agriculture. The 8th District Congress member and Undersecretary Jenny Lester Moffitt will tour the Stimilk Growers Warehouse in North Wenatchee. They also expect to announce new funding available to farmers through the USDA Specialty Crop Block Grant Program. That program offers funding for growers of fruit and nursery crops to stay globally competitive. In the past, the program has funded research into pest and disease control as well as the development of new fruit varieties. The Congresswoman will be in town around noon today. A set of bills moving through the Washington State Legislature would change the way we vote on educational bond measures. As it is now, it's a 60% supermajority is required to approve construction bonds that are larger than the school district's debt limit. Well, House Bill 1226 and a constitutional amendment would change that to a simple majority. Local educators testified on behalf of the bill earlier this week.
And I just believe that if I can win an election by a simple majority, I believe that our kids should also have access to a new school by that same margin, and look forward to perhaps seeing us move forward on this year, because it's time, it's past time.
In 2018, we had a bond on the ballot to update Wenatchee High School. The bond only got 57% of the vote, which means it didn't pass. And it meant that we couldn't update the electrical, alarm, phone, technology, security, and HVAC systems. We couldn't update 750 square foot classrooms to the recommended 900 square feet for that collaborative learning, not to mention that social distancing that we've needed to consider since 2020. Wenatchee High School was built for 1600 students, but currently houses just under 2000. Currently, you can see buckets in almost all areas of the school due to our leaking roof. The 60% threshold also creates inequities in our communities. Our neighboring Cashmere School District passed a bond in that same election, and their students saw improvements, but ours did not. Students need healthy and updated spaces to learn, and our community members want to provide that, but that supermajority makes it difficult to pass our bonds.
In 2017, 64% of school districts seeking bond levies received voter approval, resulting in $1.9 billion in new funds. The 60% standard in the Constitution is working as intended and should not be changed. The provision works whenever school officials present the community with a convincing need that gains enough votes to meet or exceed the standard. Removing the 60% rule would remove a key incentive for officials to propose reasonable and affordable public construction projects. The 60% rule gives communities meaningful input on the scope and expense of the proposed projects.
And today is the second day of judging to narrow down the field of 30 candidates to the top 10 as we get ready to name the Apple Blossom Festival Royal Court. Yesterday, it was spent getting to know the candidates from the Eastmont and Wenatchee school districts.
Good afternoon, I'm candidate Aurora Fear.
Greetings, I'm candidate Ariana Comroe.
I've been volunteering at Alethea since I was very small and I would go volunteer with my grandma. At that age, I fell in love with the horses.
And my fun fact is Americans spend more time watching others cook on television than they do cooking themselves.
Today, each of the 30 candidates will give short speeches, 2 to 3 minutes apiece, starting at 10 o'clock at the Wenatchee Convention Center. We will have that live on our Facebook page, again, beginning at 10 o'clock this morning. Then tonight at 6 o'clock, live right here on television, the top 10 announcement will be made. The 2022 Apple Blossom Festival Royal Selection Pageant will be Saturday, February 19th at 7 o'clock. And yeah, we will be there for that as well. That's what's making news. At 16 minutes after the hour, I think I'm handling the news again tonight. Fluid situation. You never know what's going on. In any event, we will have a newscast for you tonight. Guarantee you that. 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 10 o'clock, so you can be informed of what's going on in North Central Washington and the Wenatchee Valley. 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 10 o'clock. The Evening News with Eric Grandstrom handling sports. And don't forget, we'd love to hear from you. Look at the bottom of your screen. That's how you do it. Facebook, homepage, email, telephone, technology. It can be scary at times, but we embrace it. After a quick break, we're talking hockey and high school sports, plus the obscure holiday today in history, some celebrity birthdays. Everybody is entitled to Mike McNaughty's opinion. And my conversation with Linda Haglund, the executive director of the Wenatchee Downtown Association. You're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
I'm John Divis from Wenatchee Dental Arts, and I like to think myself as a comprehensive dentist. We are an office that treats people comprehensively for their dental problems. We do a lot of general dentistry in a broad sense. We don't send everything out. Things that we have the ability to do in the office, we like to keep in the office and under one roof and keep things as complication-free as possible. You can come to one place and have all their dental needs taken care of.
When your heating or cooling system is giving you trouble, call the diagnostic doctor from Dix Heating and Air Conditioning.
Here's the culprit right here.
All joking aside, when you call Dix, you're calling 35 years of experience at customer service right here in the Wenatchee Valley. Dix strongly believes in repairing before replacing, and they service all major brands of HVAC units. Sure. 18 minutes after the hour, Seattle Kraken back on the ice at Climate Pledge Arena tonight, the Nashville Predators in town to take on the Kraken. Nashville is currently third in the Western Division of the NHL. They're 26-14-3. Seattle remains last in the Pacific Division, 13-24-4, but they've won two of their past three games heading into tonight. The two teams met back in October in Nashville. The Kraken won that game 4-3. Behind a couple of goals from Brandon Tenev, they'll drop the puck at 7 o'clock tonight. The game is on ESPN+. Speaking of Tenev, Seattle's most popular player out for the rest of the year with a knee injury. He met with the media yesterday. He said he had surgery and it went well.
Our medical team here is doing a great job of getting me back on my feet, and progress is going well. And it's just it's a day-to-day process of getting better and feeling better. And it's nice to be around the guys and you know, lifting spirits here. But you know, the process is going well and surgery went well, and our team is doing a great job and helped me along the way.
So no more hockey for Mr. Tenev, but he says he wants to be involved with the Kraken any way he can, and that includes reaching out to the community.
Doing anything I can in the sense of whether it's, you know, going to meet some kids at a youth hockey clinic or taking virtual sessions or going to a hospital to see some kids in need that are ill. You know, it's just a general opportunity to connect with people in the city of Seattle, you know, and fans, individuals who have been great to the team and the organization of Seattle so far, and it's just an opportunity for myself to continue to build the brand here in Seattle, the Kraken brand, and whether that's, you know, like I mentioned, you know, spending time at a youth clinic or taking a virtual call and season ticket holders, or you know, spending time at a hospital with those in need. You know, the opportunity to build the Kraken brand is there, and I'm going to try my best to do that.
The 30-year-old forward from Toronto is also going to be joining the Root Sports Northwest broadcasting team. He's going to help out with some broadcasts of Kraken hockey.
I'm going to go up there and just try to keep things light. You know, the opportunity comes to go up there and just have some fun. Obviously, it's a different aspect that I'm not used to, and I think it's going to be an opportunity to have some fun and connect with everybody in the broadcast booth. You know, have some fun, maybe throw some subtle jabs at some teammates along the way and see how they take it. But no, it's just it's a great opportunity. You know, the team presented, and it's going to be a fun one.
If you want to watch Mr. Tenev on the broadcast, you're going to have to wait till Thursday anyway, because tonight's game is only on ESPN+. The BCHL has found the dates for the Wenatchee Wild to make up. Of course, as you know, the Wild had three games canceled or postponed anyway because of COVID, but they'll make them up in the latter part of March. The Wild will host Penticton on Wednesday the 23rd. They'll also play at Trail on Friday the 25th and Cranbrook on Saturday, March 26th. Meanwhile, Wenatchee is getting ready to host the Penticton V's this week at the Town Toyota Center. Three games. Thursday and Saturday's games will start at 6. 7:05 was when the puck will drop on Friday. Penticton is currently second in the BCHL's interior division. They're 22-6-0-2. Wenatchee comes into the series in seventh place. They are 11-12-4-1. The Wild and V's have met twice this season, Penticton winning both of those games. It was over the final two periods of the game that they lost back in early December that Wenatchee finally found its footing. Since then, the Wild have gone 8-2. Wenatchee and Penticton will meet Thursday, Friday, and Saturday here in town. Tickets, WenatcheeWildHockey.com. All right, to the Les Schwab men's college basketball scoreboard last night. Steel Venters, I just love that name, had 21 points, led three players in double figures. Eastern beats Idaho State 89-63. The Eastern women, not as lucky. They lost to the Lumberjacks 69-54. On the Les Schwab Prep Girls Basketball scoreboard from last night, that's the Idaho State Eastern scores you see there. To the Prep Girls Basketball scoreboard, Pateras peppered Wilson Creek, and Moses Lake Christian throttled Cascade Christian. Boys play last night. Again, from our friends at Les Schwab, Pateras edged Wilson Creek 57-56. Tenasket top Liberty Bell. What's going on tonight? Here's the girls' schedule. OMAC is at Cascade, 5:45. Cascade will host Royal. I'm sorry, it's OMAC's at Cashmere, I should say. Royal at Cascade. Cascade hosting Royal, I should say. Chelan visits Quincy. At 6 o'clock, you got Pateras at Cascade Christian, Tenasket to Manson, Lake Roseville at Liberty Bell. The Okanagan girls will be in Brewster. Orville is at Andy. At the boys, the same, just later on in the day. As you can see there, Royal at Cascade, OMAC and Cashmere, and Chelan and Quincy will do battle at 7:15. At 7:30, tip-off is Tenasket and Manson, Lake Roosevelt, Liberty Bell, Okanagan and Brewster, and Oroville at Antioch. Lots of girls bowling this afternoon, starting at 2 o'clock at Eastmont Lanes. The Wildcats will host Eisenhower. Wenatchee will take on Davis at 3 at Lake Bowl in Moses Lake. The Chiefs will host Sela. Wrestling tonight, OMAC will host Liberty Bell, Manson, and Oroville. They start at 5:30. Eastmont's on the road at West Valley at 6. We will have high school basketball, hopefully, on Friday night. If COVID doesn't get in the way, Eric Granstrom and Grant Olson will be courtside at the Wenatchee High School gym. Panthers hosting the Davis Pirates, Big 9 doubleheader. Girls game will be live on Facebook at 5:45. The boys game live on TV and Facebook at 7:30. The girls game will air on television, tape delay, Friday night at 10:30. And one final note. In sports, at 3 o'clock this afternoon, the Baseball Writers Association of America will unveil the inductees into the National Baseball Hall of Fame Class of 2022. Again, 3 o'clock this afternoon, we'll find out who's in. And those are just some of the games that people are playing. At 24 minutes after the hour, the obscure holiday of the day today is a paradox. It's opposite day. Yeah, I don't never much cared for opposite day. Do you celebrate opposite day or do you not celebrate opposite day? Because you're supposed to do everything the wrong way. So you get my drift. I mean, the paradox is technically this is an anti-holiday. It can't really exist because if it's a holiday, but it's opposite day, then you don't celebrate it. So it has to be the opposite of whatever you just said, which means that opposite day in theory doesn't exist. Celebrate opposite day by having breakfast for dinner. There. But be careful. Be careful with opposite day. Things can get really weird really fast if you don't tell people that you're celebrating opposite day. You can cause more harm than good. I'm going to not partake in opposite day today. Well, wait a minute, does that mean I am? I'm so confused. 25 minutes after the hour today in history. The Winter Olympics are 98 years old today. The very first Winter Olympic Games opened in Chamonix, France, in the French Alps on January 25th, 1924. The Olympic Games comes to the winter months. 16 nations send athletes to the very first Winter Olympics on this date 98 years ago today. By comparison, there were 92 nations who participated in the most recent Winter Olympics 4 years ago. The first gold medal ever awarded in Olympic winter competition went to an American, Charles Drutraw, who won the 500-meter speed skate. And for the first time in the history of the modern Olympics, the host country didn't win a gold medal. France, the host country, won three bronze medals, but they didn't win a gold. The Winter Olympics, 98 years old today. 51 years ago today, January 25th, 1971, Charles Manson and three female members of his famous family found guilty of the 1969 Tate-LaBianca murders. Charles Manson, of course, died in prison in November of 2017 at the age of 83. Susan Atkins, convicted, remained in prison until she died of brain cancer at the age of 61 in 2009. The other two females of the Manson family convicted in the homicides, Patricia Krenwinkel and Leslie Van Houten, remain incarcerated. It's off to prison for Charles Manson and his three female family members. January 25th, 1995, 27 years ago, this was really close, really nerve-wracking. We've had a couple of these incidents since the Cold War began. A couple of weeks before this event, the Americans and the Norwegians, they called up the Russians and they said, we're going to shoot off a rocket from Norway to study the Northern Lights, and we're going to do this on January 25th. So just a heads up, you're going to see a rocket on your radar. It's just going to go look at the Northern Lights, and the Russian authorities said, thanks for letting us know. Well, they forgot to tell the people in Murmansk who run the radar tracking station. They just forgot to tell them. And on January 25th, 1995, they sent the rocket up. And the radar tracking station in Murmansk said, that's a Trident missile. That was fired from a submarine. They called Moscow. They called Boris Yeltsin. Boris Yeltsin and all the top defense officials put the Russian military on full nuclear alert. They brought out the briefcase with the nuclear launch codes. They got out the codes. They put the keys into the things that would launch the missiles from the silos. And then somebody went, oh, wait a minute, that's right. That's a rocket to study the Northern Lights. They told us about it a couple weeks ago. Sorry, I forgot to tell you. Maybe should have emailed you. Close. 27 years ago today. Super Bowls, which is a registered trademark of the National Football League, all rights reserved. This is the 41st anniversary of Super Bowl XV. At Nollins, the Oakland Raiders knock off the Philadelphia Eagles to win Super Bowl 15. The Raiders becoming the first wild card team to win the Super Bowl. They became the first team to play the Super Bowl in three different decades, the 60s, the 70s, and the 80s. Of course, it was in Nollins, the halftime show, Mardi Gras, hosted by Up With People. Mardi Gras is not, it doesn't exactly celebrate responsibility and temperance, and it's about overindulging, and hosting the Mardi Gras celebration is Up With People. Let's move on to Super Bowl XXI, Super Bowl 21. It happened on this day 35 years ago today. The Giants defeat the Broncos to win Super Bowl 21 at the Rose Bowl. The Giants have been in five Super Bowls the Giants have been, but this is the only one they were actually favored to win. They were the underdogs in all the others. They scored 26 unanswered points in the third and fourth quarters to put the game away. The halftime of Super Bowl 21, a salute to Hollywood's 100th anniversary, and this was the very first Super Bowl where after the game, the MVP of the Super Bowl, quarterback Phil Simms of the Giants, said, I'm going to Disney World, which has been a tradition ever since. This was the very first I'm going to Disney World promotion that was filmed after the game at Super Bowl 21, 35 years ago today. Super Bowl XXXII, sometimes known as Super Bowl 32, was held on this date at Qualcomm Stadium in San Diego. It's gone now. The Broncos beat the Packers. Very entertaining game, 31-27. Qualcomm Stadium becomes, to this day, the only stadium to host a Super Bowl and a World Series in the same year. Later on that year, in 1998, of course, the Padres made it to the World Series. This was Denver's first Super Bowl after losing their four previous attempts. The AFC had lost the last 13 games in a row before Denver finally broke through. John Elway finally gets his victory. A remarkable fact about Denver's offensive performance: they only had two penalties, and at the end of the first half and at the end of the game, John Elway kneeled down. Outside of those four plays, Denver gained yardage on every offensive play that they ran. That is pretty remarkable. And of course, the Super Bowl was in San Diego, and so the halftime show, a tribute to Motown, which is based in Detroit. Birthdays. Still considered the most beloved athlete of the University of Oregon history, Steve Prefontaine. Born this date in 1951, died in a car accident in Eugene in 1975 at the age of 24. At the time of his death in May of 1975, Steve Prefontaine held every American outdoor track record between 2,000 and 10,000 meters. And they still hold track and field events in his honor. The Prefontaine Classic, Steve Prefontaine. Born this date in 1951. And Alicia Keys. She can sing, she can act, she can write, she plays a mean piano. Alicia Keys, 41 years old today. After a break, we have a brand new opinion from Mike Mad Dog McNaughty. We know it's new. You've never seen it because we've never aired it. And then a conversation with the executive director of the Wenatchee Downtown Association, Linda Haglund. Big plans for that group. Coming up, you're watching Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life Channel.
Are you dealing with a pest or weed issue and you just don't know what to do?
We use the best pest control methods approved for areas with kids and pets.
Whether it's rats, mice, ants, or spiders.
Or something else altogether.
We provide the coaching and solutions you're looking for.
And you can know that your dollars are supporting a local, family-owned and operated business.
Allow us to help you get back to living healthy and pest-free. Harvest Valley Pest Control.
Let Mary Maid's custom cleaning experts help you clean up your to-do list. Between work, kids, and pets, it's hard to find time to keep up. Let Mary Maid's of Wenatchee help. Mary Maid's cleaning experts can help keep your home or business fresh, neat, and exactly how you'd clean it if you only had the time. Call now for a free estimate, 509-663-1710. Serving Chelan and Douglas counties. Mary Maid's, let us help.
Hey everyone, Fletcher and Amy Ellington here from Live It Up. In the investment world, ROI stands for Return on Investment. Well, how does better health, better wealth, and better relationships sound for ROI? Join us every week right here on NCW Life and learn how to invest in the most important asset, you.
We're going to answer your questions and provide some weekly inspiration so you can create a life that you love. Join us on Live It Up.
Winter is a great time to trade in your current hot tub. Turn your old hot tub into money with Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa's trade-in program. You can save $500 to $1,000 off of any new artesian spa or take advantage of a free Bluetooth music experience. Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa recommends draining your hot tub every 3 months. Ask us about our drain and refill special. Stop on by Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa today.
Stay active and independent for life. SAIL is an evidence-based strength, balance, and fitness program. The exercises in a SAIL class have been packaged into a formal regimen focusing on four key areas important to the health and fitness of mature participants: low-impact cardiovascular, balance work, strength training, and stretching. SAIL classes are designed for people of all fitness levels and can be done sitting or standing. Join us for SAIL on the NCW Life Channel. Check your listing for days and times.
Hey, this is Mike Mad Dog McNaughty, and everybody is entitled to my opinion. Now, there's a new advertising scheme some local businesses have been using, but hiring famous people to promote their business, and this has questionable success in my mind. But hey, do what you want to promote your company. I salute, okay? If you want to hire some well-known jamoke who doesn't live here and never been here to advertise for you, go ahead. Congratulations. But one thing you better do if you have any chance of having these ads taken seriously. Make sure they pronounce the name of our town correctly. It's Wenatchee, not Wenatchee. I mean, good grief. I mean, how hard is that? This is Mike, Mad Dog McNaughty. And that's my opinion.
Are you looking at buying your first home or additional homes, perhaps an investment property or refinancing? Let the local Caliber home loan experts help guide you every step of the way. With two convenient locations to serve you in Wenatchee and Chelan, give us a call today.
News, weather, and sports. It's all here weekdays at 5, 6, and 10 on your local news source, the NCW Life Channel.
Since 1932, Camp Zuniga, nestled on the beautiful shores of Lake Wenatchee, has provided children grades 1 through 12 with the ideal location for kids to learn new skills, have fun, and make friends while creating memories that will last a lifetime. Camp Zuniga's rustic log cabins and their staff serve to provide each group a unique summer camp experience. Register for Camp Zuniga today, www.campfirencw.org.
Hi folks, welcome to Save Mart. How can we help you today?
We're looking for a recliner.
Okay, right this way.
We're gonna go ahead and move this chase on the other side. We can lift this up here.
Great, I want that one. I like that one.
That's a great choice.
And I want this one as well.
Okay.
And I definitely want this one.
Ooh. You find it at Save Mart. Full service at a low, low price.
At D.A. Davidson in Wenatchee, they believe your investment success begins with a personalized plan. A plan that is the roadmap you need to navigate your way to living your best years in retirement. D.A. Davidson can help you create a plan so you can take the time to enjoy the finer things in life. Let the financial advisors at D.A. Davidson help chart your retirement future today.
You love to help others. You need a solid career. You can have it all with help from Charter College. Our 10-month medical assistant program prepares you to work in healthcare settings like physician offices, rehab centers, and clinics. You'll learn to take patient vitals, assist with exams, administer injections, and maintain medical records. When you're ready to launch a rewarding healthcare career, visit chartercollege.edu because we work to get you to work.
Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound. Home, with my thoughts escaping. Home, with my music's playing. Home, with my love lies waiting
silently for me. Silently for me.
Let's face it, selling your good used vehicle can be a hassle, if nothing else. Consign your vehicle here at Global Elite Motors. When you do, you'll get the best possible price because of our proprietary selling system. We offer the ability to finance, add warranties, take trade-ins, and much, much more. Each consignment vehicle we represent is thoroughly inspected and marketed to attract qualified buyers. Let us help sell your quality vehicle. Buying a vehicle? Consigning a vehicle? Stop by Global Elite Motors on Wenatchee Avenue at Global Car Care.
Welcome back to Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. We'd love to put the spotlight on the Wenatchee Downtown Association because we love downtown Wenatchee. And here to talk about some of the events upcoming, they have a busy, busy late winter and early spring, making a very first appearance, by the way, on Wake Up Wenatchee Valley is Executive Director of the Wenatchee Downtown Association. Give it up for Linda Haglund.
Very first appearance this week.
This week. Very excited when I got the press release that First Fridays is back, is launching. Mm-hmm. First Fridays will begin on Friday, February 4th, and continue for as many Fridays as we can cram into it. The thought process behind that?
I'm going to guess there'll be 11 more this year.
Okay.
Well, we fully recognize that First Friday's Art Walk started before I got this job almost 11 years ago. Grassroots effort from really dedicated artisans. And First Friday's Art Walk is a going concern, and we don't want to compete with that. This is not overshadowing it. But what we heard loud and clear from our community and our merchants is that could there be something fun? Could there be a First Friday's type of format? So my board, we vision every year, and I have some dedicated people, volunteers on my board, that are merchants downtown and said, let's just launch a First Friday's downtown. So what can you expect? On our website, you're going to see a First Friday's icon that you can click on. And these businesses and restaurants and people doing things like the pack will feed information to us. And then you can go on there and see what's going on. It might be an extended happy hour in a restaurant. It could be a discount at a retailer. We're leaving it up to them. We're not going to go over the top of trying to push and structure everything, but we just think the community would like something fun consistently downtown, and it'll be First Fridays. As we move forward, obviously as we get into the summer, the opportunities to collaborate with Parks and Rec when they do their summer concert series, we can just spin this off and we hope it will grow. We're going to start small, but that's how you can find information. So kudos to my board who gave us the green light, and we're launching First Fridays Downtown Friday.
And Fridays are great because especially the first Friday of any month, for one thing, it's Friday and people want to go out and enjoy goofing off downtown. And number two, they usually have a little cash in their pocket too on that first Friday. So it's there's a lot of good thinking going on there. Your members downtown seem to handle the snowpocalypse with a great deal of aplomb. It didn't really shut things down a great deal. I mean, it was a royal pain in the rear end for a lot of people, but downtown seems to be okay when it was all said and done.
Went home Wednesday and then Thursday.
Knowing it was coming,
but, you know, I think I was in typical, in my world, people will say Linda's optimistic brain. Oh, you know, they're threatening and it's not going to be. And then I woke up to 2 feet of snow in my front yard and couldn't get to work, couldn't get out of my driveway. But, you know, it was really interesting. I have to call him out. The mayor calls me Thursday. You know, when you do a job like this and you have a great supportive city, the mayor called me and said, okay, how are we doing? What's the protocol? And the city has a protocol for snow. The city really, none of us were expecting the protocol for this much snow. So yeah, the merchants knew they had to clean the sidewalk. The question was, where do we put it? So Thursday happened, and then the city responded by bringing companies in to clear that berm. That berm was huge. And you know, I've got to say, optically, with all of that snow, it just felt claustrophobic, right? Mm-hmm. We all just felt locked in. So the sidewalks that had been shoveled, those berms were high, the middle of the street were high. So I went down Friday morning and I began to help people start shoveling out. You know, I ran into Mark and Kathy Ball, who own the Gilded Lily, and I said, Mark, do you have an extra shovel? Because can you imagine, that they're a corner, that sidewalk? And then I was able then to be able to say, let me help you. And that's what we do downtown. We're a family. And so then the city came and took the berms and you could park. But then there was this little issue of getting from your parking stall to the sidewalk without going in the street to the intersection. So we just navigated through that, and the downtown businesses responded to their employees getting to work and their customers who wanted to get to them. It was amazing. And again, I'm not surprised. They all, through COVID, have learned to adjust and adapt, and not that attitude of panic. Okay, one more, how do we do this, right? So I can't say enough thank yous to the city of Wenatchee for responding to that, so we didn't have a berm in the middle of Palouse and Wenatchee Avenue and Arondo for weeks, right? They took care of it. And because they took care of it, then the businesses could reopen and people could begin to come downtown.
And as it was pointed out by Wenatchee Public Works, it was 2 feet of snow. You can't plow 2 feet of snow. You have to physically remove it. Mm-hmm. You have to scoop it up, put them in the trucks, and take them out mm-hmm. to the apple yard mm-hmm. and dump them in the big pile. It's just mm-hmm. too much snow to mm-hmm. plow.
It's too much snow. And my hope is, again, the Pollyanna Linda's going to kick in. We're done with this, right? It could spit snow a little bit now for the end of winter, but we're done with the big snowpopolis or whatever you call it. I'm done. I'm done with snow. Let's bring spring on, right?
And we've never had 2 feet of snow in a 24-hour period mm-hmm. before. This was unprecedented. So.
Yep. Yep.
We got through it okay.
So kudos, yep.
February 23rd, the mm-hmm. annual appreciation dinner. This has been going on for 40, 50 years.
It is.
It's the big event.
It is.
It's your big annual party.
It is. And this will be my 11th year doing this job. And when I got this job, Dave Galatly, who was integral in the forming of the Wenatchee Downtown Association, at one time owned a significant amount of property downtown, he came into my office and said, have an annual dinner. Get downtown together for dinner and just celebrate downtown. And since I've got this job, we do that every year. Yes, we're fully understanding where our community is right now with COVID numbers and all of those things. But we'll follow the protocol, but this is the one time downtown gets together for dinner. And they don't know who gets awards. The mayor comes. In fact, I laugh. It's kind of a little bit of a Kuntz show because your other brother, Jim, comes and presents an award for me that night. So, but my board, and we say thank you to the people who help support us. This year, our theme for the entire year is the attitude of gratitude. We're so thankful that this community has stepped up and businesses to support this organization. We're strong. We're able, because of that support, to give back this year, and I'll talk about that on another visit of our activation grants we're going to do. We're going to be able to give some money back to people who want to do some fun things in this community. But this attitude of gratitude, so we're asking the community for help. And the help we need from the community is let us know what you're grateful for in downtown. What businesses have stepped up that you appreciate. Send that information to us, either to my email or the general Wenatchee Downtown email, because we're going to applaud these businesses and we want the community's input on that. And it's super fun when we get the community saying, you know, this happened to me, I'm so grateful for X business, right? So that will be on the 23rd. Then, back by popular demand, we used to do a beer event in the summer around Father's Day called Ale Trail. Haven't been able to do that because it competes against a large beer competition in Seattle. It just hasn't worked out. So our merchants and retailers ask us for a spring wine walk. So we're going to do it on the 12th of March, right before St. Patrick's Day. It's going to be smaller than typical. There's going to be 8 businesses participate and 4 wineries instead of 18 total. But we're going to have a modified spring wine walk and give it a try. Again, within the confines of COVID, you will get a souvenir glass to take home, but when you taste that day, it will be in small taster cups that have to be disposable. We are following all the protocols and guidelines, but here's the thing, Dan. Do we just roll over and give up and say, we'll see you when this is all over? We don't believe that's best for our community or downtown. So we're going to do everything we can within the guidelines to give some normality.
And keep in mind, that's the middle of March. So we could be, who knows where we're going to be with COVID in the middle of March. It could be, all over with or who knows.
Yeah.
We don't know. Getting back to the annual appreciation dinner. It's a celebration of downtown and the WDA. Anybody can go.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, anybody can buy a ticket. It's not limited to the downtown businesses mm-hmm. and the downtown mm-hmm. goods and services. Anybody can go.
They can. And on our website, because we have the ability now, used to be we had to use an Eventbrite or another ticketing company. We can ticket within our website. So you can just go on our website and buy a ticket. And the other thing, if you've ever attended, it's a joke, but I run a pretty tight ship. That'll shock you, right? So we start on time, we end on time. We don't keep you all night. It's, we get through this. We burn through, we don't linger. There's not auctions, there's none of that. We basically celebrate downtown, and this year, celebrate by saying thank you. And we're pretty excited that we're going to be able to have a year of really focusing on gratitude, because our organization is strong, and again, strong enough now that I'm able to, in a little bit later, talk to you about a community Christmas tree I was able to purchase and what that's going to look like. And then also we'll be doing these, I'll talk about later, summer activation grants in June, July, and August to maybe do some fun activities downtown and give people money to do that.
Last time I talked to you, and we'll close out with this, with Linda Haglund, the executive director of the WDA. I go through downtown a couple times a week anyway, usually to eat. A lot of good restaurants downtown. I always excited to see the old buildings that they got particle board and plasterboard over it, but they got coming soon or improvements. It's a big tease for me. Anything that you want to, you've seen them, you know them.
I do.
You know what's going on behind the scenes with some of the remodels going on.
I do, and I can honestly say that we have only one space available downtown for lease. And it is also the building that is for sale, the old Rialto Theater, Bandbox, mm-hmm. right? Remember that?
Sure.
It is between Palouse and Arondo on the east side of the street. That is for sale, and that is the only building that I know of today for sale, and we hope that will sell. The rest of the empty spaces are in renovation right now. And so I'm hearing rumors of stuff coming up, but nothing I can report on.
Fair enough.
But there is renovation going into six spaces right now downtown, which is pretty exciting. So that means something new is coming. But I think what you're feeling in downtown, and as we process through, looping back to First Fridays, as you process through, you're going to begin to see, obviously, when the weather gets a little bit better, this nighttime vibe now in downtown. I saw it at the end of last year, particularly with what was going on with 108 Doors Open, Watermill, Stone's Gastro Pub. That block across from the convention center, I went, whoa, right? It felt so. I think you're going to begin to see more of that. And this is going to be a pretty exciting summer downtown. I think that we're going to probably for the first time have what people have been crying for is a nighttime vibe downtown. And there hasn't been one, honestly, in a long time, other than going to a restaurant and eating, right?
That's the nice thing about all of these old historic buildings downtown. They were so over-engineered and over-constructed to begin with that it gives somebody who's remodeling or renovating a blank slate with knowing that the skeleton is as good as it's going to get. And they get all blinky-eyed and say, I get to work in this space. It's fantastic.
Yeah. So. And applauding those new property owners. And also I need to give a kudos to the Regional Port Authority, not because we all have a connection to them, including you, but their visionary work on Columbia Street and then what will happen on Fifth Street with the PUD vacating. This will be a totally different downtown 5 years from now, right? With that same historic old town feeling. But what is coming is pretty exciting, and I can't wait, right? I usually don't push the future too fast, but I can't wait for these things to take an effect and that what people are going to be able to do in this downtown. It's going to be super fun.
First Fridays begins Friday, February 4th, and will be the first Friday of every month for the rest of the year. And, of course, the big annual appreciation dinner on February 23rd. You can get your tickets by going to WenatcheeDowntownAssociation.org. Which is where I'm at right now, right in front of me. Mm-hmm. Linda, it's always good to see you.
Thank you.
And I'll see you, I don't know, a month or so, right?
For the first time again.
Yeah, for the first time again. Linda Haglund, the executive director of the WDA. Give her a up. Oh, the crowd loves you. You're watching Wake Up in Wenatchee Valley. We'll be right back.
Hey folks, Carrie from Blueberry Hills. A chill is in the air and it's a perfect time for some old-fashioned comfort food like our amazing Eggs Benedict, chicken fried steak, French dips, soups made from scratch, or fruit pies fresh from the oven. The crowds might be gone, but we're still here for you folks. So bring an appetite and a friend to Blueberry Hills in Manson, where you pick, you sit, you eat, and you visit. Open Wednesday through Sunday from 8 to 3, wildaboutberries.com.
When Mike leaves town, it's a little scary. You never know who might be outside. But we feel safer inside knowing our home is being monitored by a local company. I can check our alarm from just about anywhere. So when we get home, I know it's safe.
Protect your family and save money with a local company. Switch your current security monitoring to Guardian Services from Localtel. Call Guardian Security from Localtel now or visit localtel.net to learn more.
There are so many possibilities for you to learn local right here at Wenatchee Valley College. Take classes towards a degree or a certificate in more than 50 areas of study. Wenatchee Valley College now offers a large variety of virtual classes, including labs, sign language, music, and machining, and they have the resources to help you succeed in virtual classes. So when a college degree is your goal, learn local at Wenatchee Valley College.
Did you know that nearly 50% of pet poisoning cases involve human medications and prescription drugs? Sometimes the culprit's a curious dog, but cats get into their share of trouble as well. Other times, pet owners mistakenly give their pets their own medications that are safe to people, but toxic to their pets. Dr. Shauna Bayes and her staff care about your pets. Go to pawsandclawsvh.com for a complete list of medications to avoid or call 888-PAWS.
Five minutes to go on this program before we do the forecast for you one more time. A fun little video for you. We're going to go back to Friday, the seventh day of this month, shortly after Snowpocalypse. And you know we have these cameras all over the place, the BTZ cameras that we use, like what you see behind me right now. We also have one on our building here in downtown Wenatchee. And Friday afternoon, after Tucker Wagner finished another hard week of work, he decided it was time to go home in his cute little blue truck. Here you go. And special thanks to Malcolm Nathaniel Whitehall for getting the footage and trying to help Tucker out of that delicate situation. He did eventually make it home. The sun has been up for about 45 minutes. Take a quick little look-see around north central Washington to see what we're dealing with. We're going to see a little more sunshine today than we saw yesterday, but don't bet on a whole bunch of sunshine. Just a few breaks in the afternoon. I want to say that's maybe Valley High. That's the Valley High camera on your way up to Blue Pass. By the way, no advisories or restrictions on any of the major mountain passes, and no snow in the forecast for the Cascades until we get to Sunday. Camera number two, up to Lake Wenatchee we go. Lake Wenatchee got more sunshine than we did yesterday. They got quite a bit of it. Once the sun got up high enough in the sky to burn off the clouds and the fog, that will happen again today at Lake Wenatchee from the Nanapoc Ridge camera. Beautiful above the cloud cover. Below it, not so much. Camera number three. That maybe jump off? Yep. Okay, I'm guessing. I don't know. What am I looking at here? That's the Waterville camera. Okay. Hello, Waterville. You're down there. And again, up above the cloud deck. So there you go. And camera number four. Number one canyon? Okay. So now we're right back to the Wenatchee Valley with the clouds and the fog and the stratus that's going to be hanging around. This pattern isn't going to change much. Next week, though, things are going to mix it up a little bit. We have a better than 50-50 chance of below normal temperatures and above normal precipitation. As far as snow down here in the valley, we're not too sure about that yet. Certainly the Cascades are finally going to get some more snow after having an extensive dry period. So get ready for some change coming, but we got to get there first. In the meantime, here's what we're looking at. The clouds and the fog will burn off a little bit earlier today. We will see some sun breaks in the afternoon. We'll get up to about 30. That's what we hit yesterday, 22 for the overnight low tonight. And then the clouds and the fog are going to have the upper hand on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. We could still get some very late afternoon sun breaks. But for the most part, we're going to be stuck down here with temperatures just about normal. Things finally start warming up a little bit on Saturday and Sunday, and then active weather returns early next week into February. And that's it for us. Have a great Tuesday. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.